Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials on any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then please write me at contact@devopsschool.com. Thank you.
Okay, so this is my root account. So I logged in with a root account, and then if I go to users, I have the unit for you. So these are my users, student 1 to 20. And I have given you certain permissions. So suppose if I go to student 1, so these are the permissions I have given to you. So power user access is the permission I have given to you. Now, if you with this existing user, if you try to go to IAM, you will get an error saying that some of the things are not visible. Can you just try and go to IAM? I give you error. That is because I have not given you full permissions on IAM, right? So let me try to do this, and let me add permissions. Let me just go to groups. So I'll add another policy that is called administrator access. So with the help of this, now you will be able to perform all the tasks. Now, can you just try and go to the IAM console? You will be able to see everything. Are you able to see?
Yes.
Right. So because I have changed the permissions and I have given you full permissions, so you are as good as root. So be careful when you perform certain activities. Now, so you are having all the privileges now. So let us add a user. So you can go to users. And add a user. Now, currently you're logged in as student 1, 2, 3, etc. And since you have the privileges already, you are going to add another user, right? So let me add a user with my name, Srikant. So similarly, you can do that. And two types of access are there. One is the programmatic access. So if somebody is using AWS CLI or SDK, that kind of access can be given, or console access can be given. So let me first try and give console access. And I will say custom password. And I will just give a password. I will just require password reset. To simplify this, I will just disable that. And next, I will say permissions. Now, there are three options here. Add user to group.
Hello?
Yeah. Yes.
Shikant, wait. Actually, we are not getting your voice. I think you're talking, we are not getting.
Oh, is it? One second.
No, we are able
is
to.
Is
it? Is clear.
Hello?
Yeah.
I think you have some problem, local issue.
Try
I think
to
you,
connect.
You are having issue. Yeah, I think for others it is fine. So there are three options here. Add user to group, copy permissions from existing user. We will go with the third option, attach existing policies directly. So I created a user, Srikant, and now I'm trying to give certain permissions to this user. So I will say, please search for a policy called power user access. So this is the predefined policy by Amazon. I will just attach this policy to this user and review and create the user. Okay. So this user is now created. Okay. So this is my user. Now I will go back to IAM and my is added here. Okay. Now I want to, this is the IAM user, right? Under my root. So, or under basically your login. So now I want to log in as this user and see what activities I will be able to do on AWS platform. So how do you do that? You go to dashboard. This is a link I have shared with you, right? So let me copy this link and let me just put it here. So let me just put it here. So for me, I have logged in as root, so it will ask me to reload, and then you will get the same screen what you have been getting so far. So that is I login screen. And so this is the my ID and this is the IAM user. So now this time I'm going to log in as user Srikant. And this is the password. So I'm a user with the policy power user access. And now if I go to EC2, and I can see that I will be able to all the activities. I can go to running instances, I can stop instances, terminate instances, create instances, etc. So this is the user and the root account, right? But I am able to perform all the activity. This is coming from a policy called power user access, right? Now if I go to IAM, now what you have done is you logged in with a user student, and now you have created another user and you have given the permission power user access to that user. You logged in as that user. Now if you try to go to IAM, you will get an error saying that you are not authorized to perform some other activity. That is the error you are getting. So you encountered the following error. So this is not authorized to perform. So get account summary is the call under the IAM service, and I am not permitted to execute this call. Okay, so that is the meaning of this. Now let me log out and log in as root again. What you can do, you can log out and log in as your student user, so that now you have the privileges, so you will be able to do all the activity as a root user, as good as a root user. So let me sign in. So here it is asking, it is giving me this page, but I don't want to use the IAM user. For you, you'll have to log in as IAM user as student 1 to 20. I'm going to log in as root user. So there is a separate link here, sign in using root user. For you, you have to use the same link, same way you have what you have been using. And now okay, so I'm now root. You will be student one to whatever username. Login as that. Fine. So let me go to users and let us see how the policy looks like. So let me search for users recon. So this is the policy. Okay. Now if I click this arrow here, and if I click on, let it populate. If I click on JSON, so this is the JSON code what we have. So all the internally the policies are kept in the JSON format. And if you look through the statements, first is the version, then you have the statement. So the first is effect is allow. Effect is allow. Not action on IAM star, organization star, and account star, and resources star. Resources star means any resource. And I'm in this statement, I'm allowing everything on all resources. That means all actions on EC2, all actions on S3, everything allowed, except I'm not taking any action in this statement on IAM organization and account. So IAM organization account are three services, and star means all the APIs under that or all the actions under that service. The first statement says I am allowing everything on all other services, but not taking any action on IAM organization and account. So what is the next statement? Again, it is allow. Action is IAM create service link role, delete service link role, list roles, organization, describe organizations. So these actions I am allowing, only these actions on IAM and account and organization. So all other actions on IAM, I am denied, because I have not put any explicit rule regarding that. So power user access permissions, if I assign it to a user, he will be able to perform all activities on all the services except IAM. And on IAM, I will be able to perform this only this 4-5 activities. Okay, other than that, I cannot do anything in IAM. Okay. So that is how this policy will work. Okay. Now let us see another policy which I have assigned to you currently, and that is admin access. So if I search for admin access, administrator access. So let me just take that policy. So if you see here, everything is allowed. So it is effect is allowed, action is star, resource is star. So that is why you are able to do everything as good as root on this AWS platform. Okay. Fine. So let us come back to users. Let me go again to this user. That is about the policies. Let us come to the security credentials. So here I have given him the console password. There is a facility to give him multi-factor authentication. So if you say manage here, It is difficult to show on a remote session, but what you can do, you can configure your phone as a multi-factor authentication device. If you go ahead with the virtual MFA, or there are other hardwares also which are supported. So you'll have to order this and you will get a token. So you might have used the RSA token where the numbers keep on changing. So it is a similar device. If you want to go ahead with virtual MFA, what it will do is, let me just show you how to configure it. So if I go ahead and say this QR code will be shown, and on your phone, you need to have two applications. One is the QR code reader or a barcode reader or a scanner, and another one is Google Authenticator, right? So Google Authenticator and barcode reader. Okay, if you have these two, what you need to do from the mobile is invoke this application, Google Authenticator. It will ask you to scan the barcode. So it is given you the barcode here. You need to scan it, and then it will start generating random numbers. Okay, just like your RSA token. And two consecutive numbers you need to feed in here, and then your phone will become your MFA device. So how it is used, basically the user tries to log in with the help of a password, there will be another screen which will ask him the MFA device code. So he need to enter that, and then he will be allowed to enter the AWS console. Okay, so that is another feature, MFA. Okay, so that is about the user. So, any questions on this?
So this MFA device, if we enabled it, and I mean, if we lost that phone, so will I be able to log in the AWS console?
No. So basically, what you need to do, you will not be able to, unless admin or a root user disables it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. So somebody should, with the admin privileges, should have his phone intact, and he should be able to log in and manage it.
Okay.
While scanning the barcode, do we need to install any app or?
Yeah, so two apps are required, Google Authenticator and Barcode Scanner. When you run Google Authenticator, it will ask you to scan the code. So in that, it will
Your voice is breaking, Srikant.
Breaking, Srikant.
No, it's still breaking.
And then you scan the code, and immediately it will start generating random numbers, consecutive numbers. Then is it okay now?
Yeah,
or it's still breaking.
It's okay now.
Fine.
Fine. So that is the MFA concept. Now another thing. So far we have been doing everything through the AWS console, but there is a command line tool that is available that is called the AWS CLI. And now what I'm going to show you, if you go to the aws.amazon.com/CLI. So this is the command line interface, and you can download it. So I suggest you are working on a remote desktop, So on that machine, you just click this 64-bit link, and then the one MSI file will download on that machine. Just double click it and try to install it. Let me see if you are able to install. So this is the AWS command line interface. Then I will show you how to use it. Just go ahead and install it. Don't install on your laptop, install it on a remote machine.
Can you repeat how to install it?
Go to this site aws.amazon.com/cli.
Okay.
Then on the right side, for Windows, you will see download and run 64-bit installer.
Okay, fine.
So once you install it, how to check it, go to command prompt and just type AWS. So it should return you some help. That means it is installed.
For me, it shows as not recognized internal or external command. Yeah.
Check the path. Just check the path.
Path so that is there in the users.
To go to C drive. Yeah. So go to C drive. Go to users. And you should see in my programs.
Okay.
A folder called AWS.
Okay.
Program files.
AWS in command.
Not users. The program files. You will see one folder called AWS.
Okay.
So just set your path or CD to that directory and then try to run it.
Okay.
Here you will see, say it's on not AWS, Amazon, and you will have a folder called AWS. Just go there and try to run it.
Okay.
What it should return, Trikant, once we invoke AWS?
It should return help.
Yeah, okay.
So that means it is installed.
Okay.
Yeah, now it's okay.
Okay. Fine. Now let us see how to use this. So basically, for using this, you need the access key and secret access key. So go to the user what you have created, and under security credentials, you will see access keys. So let us create this access keys. And you can, it is a CSV file, so just download it. It has got two keys, access key and secret access key. So download it. So let me close this and open those. Open that file. This is the file which is having access key and secret access key. Okay, so to use this tool, we need to configure it with this access key and secret access key. So how do you do that? The command is AWS configure. So you need to take this key and paste it here. Then you need to take the secret access key. And it will ask you the default region. So you'll have to give a technical name of the region. So put it as US East. Dash one. Don't put 1A, 1B. Those are availability zones. So you, everything small in small letters, US East one. Then it will ask for a default output format. Just enter. Don't enter anything. It is none. None means the default format is JSON format. Okay. So now we have configured this tool. So what we have done, we have created a user, given him programmatic access, has given us access key and secret access key. We run the command AWS configure, and we have configured this. Fine. Now let us run a command. Now the command syntax is, first command is AWS. The main command, and then you need to give the service name. Suppose on S3 I want to run the command, and under service S3 there are sub commands. The first command is AWS S3 ls. So ls will list all the buckets. So let me just run this. Okay, so this is listing all the buckets for me. Now what are the different formats of this CLI? Those are mentioned there. Go to the AWS CLI. There is a CLI reference guide. So almost everything that can be done through console can also be done through command. Let me just open this up.
To get our channel membership, click on to the join button, select the 399 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
Okay, if I scroll it down, these are the services which are supported in AWS CLI. So if I go to S3, for example, So let us see what are the sub commands which are supported. Taking some time to load. Okay, in that time it loads. Okay, so this is the page. So it will give you all the commands here. Okay. Fine. So these are the commands. So you can, if you want to sync a particular directory from here to on S3, you can do that. Sync MBS make bucket, remove bucket, ls. Do you have copy? So you can LWS S3 CP from the local, you can copy to bucket, etc. Okay, so all these are the command, which are the S3 commands you can give from a command line tool. So let me just show you. How to create a bucket. So AWS S3 and then make bucket. The format is S3 colon double forward slash, and suppose I give a name fidelity2. Will create this bucket. Okay, so this is my bucket we created. Now if I say AWS S3 LS, it should list this. It is listing it. Now suppose I want to copy something from my local this, sorry, here. So suppose there is a file called test.txt and I want to copy it to the bucket, I can do that. S3 cp test.txt and
Shikhan, when I try to do S3 LS, it's showing as bootcode.aws request. Some error is showing. I'll put it in the chat.
Bootcode AWS request. Access denied for S3 bucket. Getting this error. Okay. So just check your permissions. Which is your user?
Ashok.
For me also same. Can you check for student 7?
Can you spell it for me?
Student 7.
No, which is the user you have created? Or from student 7 you are trying to do it?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Administrator access, fine. So you have the permissions. Why it is giving you this error? No, you are not create access key.
Oh, okay.
So you need to configure that like we did, no? AWS configure, you need to give access key, secret access key, your default region, and then it will work.
Okay.
Yeah, I have created all those things, Shrikant. So check whether my user is showing in there. User is Ashok.
Mm-hmm. I don't see your user. Ashok, is it ASH okay or?
ASH okay. I'm able to view those things.
Where is your user?
Ashok, did you create a separate user or?
Now it is showing. Okay.
Okay.
So let me check.
Okay.
There is no permission. Yeah, what is that? Let me. It is okay. Administrator access. Yeah, it is there. No yes. problem. So what you have done? This is coming from a. You have created a group.
Yeah.
Srikant, can you share the syntax for configuring the access AWS configure?
AWS configure the command.
I'm sorry?
AWS configure is the command.
Okay.
You are not, see Ashok, you are not created access keys. See,
below have created it. Access create access key, right? So I have created it.
Yeah, I am not sure. It is my own. It is there. Okay, fine. Yeah. So have you done AWS configure?
Yeah, done.
No. I think you have done some mistake. Can you share your screen? I will make you present.
Yeah, sure.
Where is you? What's your full name? Ashok Kumar, right?
Yes.
Yeah. You can share your screen so that I can guide you.
Yeah, this is what I'm getting. AWS configure, and I have passed the access key and secret access key, then default region and default output.
Share your screen.
I think.
Voice is breaking.
I think Srikant has
share the screen.
Default region name.
Share the screen. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I have shared it. Yeah. Able to see my screen?
Yeah, that is what.
Okay.
No. That's fine. So run the command AWS configure. I just do a CLS so that I will be able to use. Okay. 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 So default region name US-East.
US-East-1. Okay.
Enter.
Okay. Yeah, enter. Format. Okay.
None. So, now run the command.
Access denied.
No, I'm not able to see your screen. Just scroll down.
Yeah, 1 second. I'll get to you.
This bucket operation is denied, right?
Yeah.
output format man US East 1 access key, secret access key. Default username is one. Okay. Okay. Just go back to console and create a different access key next time.
Okay. It's giving the same key, I think. So okay.
It will be different key. Download okay. The CSV.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, I'll pass on this.
Now configure again and see. Let's scroll down. Let's see.
Yeah. Oh, it's showing the same error. Access denied.
Okay, let me just check. Give the control back to me. Let's see.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, given.
Okay. Oh, Ashok, you didn't attach the policy.
Yeah, it should be access, not administer user access.
Why this is very, very slow. That's permission. Administrator yeah, access. See, group name is users. There's no user.
Yes.
Have you no, that is okay. Now administrative access is the permission coming from a group, right? So let me just click this group. Did you create this group user?
No. Whatever it shown there, have chosen that.
No. What has happened is, I think you did not directly attach the permissions. You said group,
okay.
And so the group was not created. That is the error. So do one thing.
Yeah, now it's working.
Attach the permissions directly.
Yeah, I have chosen admin. Now it's working. Yeah.
Okay. Fine. So all others are able to access. Fine. So let me go to the command prompt, and I want to now say AWS EC2 describe
hello
instance. Yeah,
Shrikant, actually I'm facing some issue. I lost you from past 15 minutes. Your voice is not audible. Okay, go ahead.
No, what happened? Yeah, tell me what happened.
He lost you, it
Hello?
Seems.
Lost you, it seems, Shrikant.
Okay.
He's having some internet issues.
Not internet issue. Actually, I connected from my laptop and I'm unable to hear you. So I connected from my mobile.
Yesterday also I faced the same issue. I'm using HPD, so just restarted it, then start working.
So this is the command I'm running. So it is on. Currently we did something on S3. Now this is the command AWS EC2 describe instances. So whatever things you see on the console, you will be able to get it in a JSON format. Okay. Fine. So there are number of services which are supported on CLI. Now where you can use it? You can use it for automation purpose. Suppose we have seen the how to create a snapshot of particular volumes, right? Can we do it programmatically? Definitely we can. So we can make use of AWS CLI. So I'll just show you a sample script of creating the backup. Yeah, so this is a bash script, but there are only 3 lines. Let's open that. Those who understand bash, they can. For others also it is very simple to understand. So what is happening here is this is a for loop, and when I say for volume in, so in the dollar, when I enclose something in the bracket with a dollar, it is actually called command substitution. So in case of bash, so this will execute this command, and whatever the output, one by one these values will come in the volume variable. Okay, so what I have done is when you give this command AWS EC2 describe volumes, it will give you in the JSON format. So to create a snapshot, we need to pass the volume ID to this command. So if you look at the second command, AWS EC2 create snapshot, you need to pass the volume ID. The volume ID is coming in the variable volume. Now, what is this JQ? JQ is the parser, which is JSON parser, which is available on Linux. So you can just do yum install JQ and it will get installed. So the utility is you can parse it. The output JSON format output, you can parse it. So I have parsed it for volumes and volume ID. So you'll, with this command, you will get the list of volume IDs. But the volume IDs will be enclosed with quotes. So to take care of that, there is a sed command. So sed will substitute those quotes with nothing. And so what you will end up, output of this command will be list of volume IDs. And one by one, that will, because of the for loop, it will go into this volume variable. And the next command will create the snapshot. Okay. So this is a small script, 3-4 line script. With the help of which you can automate this task. And so you can schedule it maybe through ProntTab to run it at 12 o'clock in the night. It will take all the backups. So this is a small example of how to automate things using AWS CLI. Okay, so CLI, you can embed it into your Bash script.
This is to back up the EBS volume.
EBS volume, yes.
Okay.
So similarly, you can do anything. You can actually create a EC2 instance. You can keep on monitoring through CloudWatch. So auto scaling we did through a wizard, but similar things can be done through trigger a EC2 instance depending upon certain metrics in CloudWatch. Suppose say CPU utilization is high, you want to trigger an additional instance. You can do that. Okay. So almost all services are supported in the AWS CLI, and you can make use of this. Fine. So we have discussed users.
Yes.
Hello. In the script you want to see?
Can I just ping a code snippet to the chat so that it will be easy for us?
You want to put. Now, what do you want?
Just you can post this in the chat, chat. Srikanth. Yeah. This code.
Oh, this script you want? Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
So this you need to do it on Linux machine.
Okay.
So you need to install JQ and then do it. So we discussed about users. Now we know how to install command line tool, how to configure it and run commands. Groups concept, I have already explained it to you. When you don't want to give permissions directly to the user, you can create a group, give the permissions to the group and assign users to this group. So in a corporate environment, you can make use of groups. It is always a good practice to make use of groups rather than assigning policies directly to the user. So in a corporate environment, some are admins, some are DBAs, some are testers, and they need specific access on AWS platform. So create those groups, assign those policies to them, and then they will get the appropriate permissions. Another thing is roles. So what is the use of a role? A role comes into picture when one service wants to talk to another service. So for example, okay, so one service wants to talk to another service. For example, in yesterday's scenario, suppose this is a S3 bucket, and on a particular event, I want to trigger a Lambda function. Then what I can do, when the file gets uploaded, it will generate an event and it will trigger a Lambda function. Now in this scenario, there are two services talking to each other, right? So the Lambda function will be triggered automatically. You are not invoking it yourself, right? On an event, it is going to invoke. But a Lambda function should be able to talk to S3 bucket. So that means two services are talking to each other. So that is done through a role. That is done through a role. So when I create a role and assign it to a Lambda function, and the role will have a policy that it will be able to read S3 buckets. So Lambda can read this S3 bucket on our behalf, right? So there is no user sitting there, but Lambda from service, as a service is talking to another service. So that is exactly the where role comes into play. So there are different scenarios in which roles can be used. So suppose I say create a role. So I'll just explain those. So the first scenario I just explained, AWS service. One service talks to another service. Then that can happen through a role. Another scenario is another AWS account. So suppose I have two accounts. Let me just draw this. So there are two accounts. I have one account here, AWS account, and other account in the sense I have two root accounts. What I mean is account. And in this account, I have created some, say, S3 bucket. And I am another, say, Srikant is the name of the user in this account under root. And I want to, this fellow wants to give permissions on this S3 bucket. But this Srikant user is in another root account. So I can set up a role. And I can basically assign the policy so that, say, S3 full access. And then, so Srikant user can log in and change the role. Okay, that is how it will happen. Okay, so for that also, role can be used. So this is scenario number two. So I can give a specific account that can use this role. So I will have to give the other account detail, other account ID. Like for me, there is a ID here. If I go to my account, there will be email ID, email, or there is a unique ID. So ID, I need to put it there and then create a role so that if a person logs in from that account, he can change the role. Okay. So this is my ID I need to put. Okay. Fine. So this is another way. So one is the service to service you want to communicate, or from one account to another account. Third thing is wave identity federation. So what is this? Now you have S3 bucket or some kind of resource in your account. Now you want to give access to a third party, but the third party doesn't have an AWS account. Okay, so suppose this is my S3 bucket, and programmatically I want to give access to another user who doesn't have an AWS account, but he has a Google account. He has got a Gmail account. Then Google will be used as a authenticator. So you will log into this Gmail, and then I can assign certain permissions on my S3 bucket. This also happens through a role. So there is a service called as secure token service. This is only possible through programmatic access. Through console, you cannot do it. So STS is the service, secure token service. So what happens is, once it gets authenticated on Gmail, he will get us temporary access credentials. And there will be a time limit. So maybe for that time, there will be a TTL value. Till that time, he will get the access. So what is actually happening in the background? It is assuming this, he is assuming this role. And this role, there are certain policies attached. So through those policies, he will get that access. Okay, so that is scenario number three. Now actually there is, let me see if that demo works here.
Please enroll our general membership for $399 plan to get access of all the parts.
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the 3D99 plan and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.